of a testimony. It's a program with a testimony inside it. Many of us have grown up in Sunday school since we were little, I'm included, and we learned all the stories about Jesus. And that's kind of the basis of this program tonight. And I hope you hear the message that's in it and that you enjoy it. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, for this evening. Thank you for allowing us to be here in your house. And Lord, we ask that our hearts be open to the message included in this program and that we hear what's needed to be heard personally and as a group. For it's in your Son's ever precious name that we pray. Amen. Well, as I said, I grew up in Sunday school. And part of that was growing up in a small town. As everyone knows, growing up in a small town is a unique experience. Everyone knows each other. You know, you go down the street and you say hi, you wave at everyone. Everyone attends the annual holiday events like the Christmas parade, Easter egg hunt, Memorial Day service, and the 4th of July fireworks display. Friday nights during the fall meant going to the high school football games. Saturdays in the spring and summer, you usually found everyone at the baseball field. And Sunday mornings found everyone going to church. Proverbs 22:6 says, train a child in the way he should go, and when he grows old, he will not turn from it. Well, some of my fondest memories were going to Sunday school and church with my grandmother as a little child. I loved going to Sunday school. I would play with my friends and sing lots and lots of songs. But my favorite part of Sunday school was listening to wonderful stories from a very special book.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone, a word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
Oh, yeah.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. You'll find it in the motel, in the nightstand by your bed.
About exciting and interesting people. People like Noah, who built a huge ark, Joseph and his amazing dreams, and Moses, who parted a sea. Stories about a young boy named David, who defeated a giant named Goliath. Daniel, who was thrown into a lion's den, and Jonah, who was swallowed by a whale. These amazing stories of events captivated me as a young child. It's one group of stories I'd love to hear over.
Okay, so, oh.
Tell me the story of Jesus, right on my heart every word. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever.
Glory to God.
stories of Jesus fill me with wonder and awe. Angels sang about his birth. Shepherds came and worshipped him. And kings traveled from great distances and bowed down to him. As a child, I could not understand how a tiny baby born in a small stable could be so important. In Sunday school, I learned many of the Bible verses from these stories. I learned the golden rule, which says, do unto others as you would have done unto yourself. I also learned a verse about loving my neighbor, and my favorite verse about God's love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. John 3:16. Well, as I grew older, I learned different stories about Jesus in Sunday school. Some stories told of how he asked fishermen to become fishers of men. Other stories told of lessons of trusting and having faith in God. But many of the stories talked about the extraordinary things he did. Loaves of bread and two fish, and calmed the sea with only a few words. Although I had grown older and was able to understand more about the stories, I still wondered why he did all these amazing things. Well, after Sunday school, I would meet my grandmother in the sanctuary of the church. I would sit beside my grandmother and sing hymns. And when it came time for the pastor to speak, I would sit still and draw pictures on the church bulletin. I didn't always understand what the pastor was saying or was talking about. I just knew that he was telling me God loved me, but I still did not understand why. Matthew 11:15 says, "He who has ears, let him hear." As a teenager, I learned more about God's love in Jesus. Although I knew all about the miracles through the stories in the Bible, I still did not completely understand what they meant. However, all that would soon change. It was Easter Sunday, and in Sunday school, I heard the same story of how Jesus had died for my sins and rose from the dead. I had heard the story, many times before as a young child, but I still did not comprehend the full meaning of the story. After Sunday school, I met my grandmother and the rest of my family in the sanctuary. A special Easter service was being presented. The choir began by singing "Tell Me the Story of Jesus," one of my favorite hymns. The pastor welcomed everyone to the service, and after the pastor finished the announcements, the puppets performed for Children's Church. Singing that song as a young child in Sunday school. The simple message of Jesus' love was beautiful. After the puppets finished, and the choir director led the congregation in a few hymns that told of God's love. If you'll take your hymnals, I'd like to lead you in those songs. The first song is hymn 344, "Jesus Loves Me."
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me. Tells me so. Jesus loves me. wash away my sin. Let his little child come in. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me still, though I'm very weak and ill. From his shining throne on high comes to watch me where I lie. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me. He will stay close beside me all the way. If I love him when I die, he will take me home on high. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
And if you'll turn back to hymn 141, The Old Rugged Cross.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to the Calvary. So I'll cherish the my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. In the old rugged cross, stained with blood so divine, such a wonderful beauty I see. For 'twas on that old cross Jesus suffered and died to pardon and sanctify me. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true, its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then call me someday to my home far away, where His glory for the world shares. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
And if everyone will stand as they turn to hymn 330, Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and of Amazing Grace had been sung, everyone sat down. And just like every Sunday before this one, the tithes were collected and the choir sang a special song. Before he began his sermon, the pastor prayed. However, the pastor did something different. Normally, he would thank God for allowing us to be in his house for blessings and healing. But today, he prayed that the word of God would speak to everyone's heart and let us hear what we needed to hear.
Finding myself at a loss for words, and the funny thing is, it's okay. The last thing I need is to be heard, but to hear what you would say. Word of God, speak. Would you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know that you're in this place. Please let me stay. God speak. I'm finding myself in the midst of you, beyond the music, beyond the noise. All that I need is to be with you, and in the quiet hear your voice. Word of God, speak. Would you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know that you're.
Easter message, I started to understand all the stories I'd learned from the Bible in Sunday school. Every story spoke of God's love for his people, but the most important story was of how he sent his only son Jesus to save someone like me. Tell me the story of Jesus. Write on my heart every word. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever was heard. Tell how the angels in chorus sang as they welcomed his glory to God in the highest, peace and good tidings to earth. Tell me the story of Jesus, write on my heart every word. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever was heard. Fasting alone in the desert, tell of the days that are past, how for our sins he was tempted, yet was triumphant at last. Tell of the years of his labor. Tell of the sorrow he bore. He was despised and afflicted.
of Jesus. Write on my heart every word. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever was heard. Tell of the cross where they nailed him, writhing in anguish and pain. Tell of the grave where they laid him. Tell how he liveth again. Love in that story so tender, clearer than ever I see. Stay, let me weep while you whisper. Love paid the ransom for me. Tell me the story of Jesus. Write on my heart every word. Tell me the story most precious, sweetest that ever was heard.
That Easter Sunday changed my life forever. The Bible was no longer a book full of wonderful stories that captivated me as a young child. And all the stories of Jesus I had learned in Sunday school, well, they took on a whole new and wonderful meaning.
Water at the store and the ground.
you enjoyed the program, and I hope it spoke to you, because I know many of you are like me and grew up in Sunday school, and you heard all the stories. But it's what the story actually means that is what this was about. So I hope as you leave, as we go to fellowship, that you think about what was sung, what the puppets did, and what was said.